Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. You know, I'm so sorry. I have to break my promise to you guys that I was not going to do a map tutorial for quite a while, but it was just brought to my attention from one of the viewers that there is an even easier way to do a dashed slash dotted line animation on a map than I did, and I thought I would share that with you guys. So again, Frank, thank you for giving me the heads up with the way of doing this super easy line animation inside of the DaVinci Resolve 17's Fusion. If you are new to this channel and want to learn DaVinci Resolve filmmaking tips and tricks and want to have a look at some pretty cool gear, I would recommend you to subscribe. Also, if you want to join the Facebook group, that would be awesome because I want to do a community over there as well. Also, you could just join this channel by pushing the join button down below. Alrighty, with that out of the way, let's get right to this video. Okay, so let's just get right to this tutorial. Here I have a map and I'm going to make this into a Fusion clip. With that done, I'm going into Fusion. So I'm just going to highlight both of my media in and my media out. And now I'm just going to add in a text note and I'm going to merge that together with the media one. So I'm going to add in image that way. Okay, so with that selected, let's do a lot of dash lines. And we'll go into the layout. And I'm going to change this from point to path. And in this case, I'm going from, I think, America to England. And then I'll go all the way down here to Australia for my travel map here. And I'm going to make sure that I have enough dashed lines so the route will be correct. Let's say something like this should be good enough. Then I am going to change the color to, let's say, a reddish color. And the cool thing about doing it this way is actually I'm going to push my control button here and I'm going to zoom in so I can see my dot. So we can change the size if we want. We could also change the font and also the tracking. We can change that so it won't be as close. It's going to go out again. And now, of course, we have added in a little too many dots. So we can just delete some of them until our path is what we want it to be. Something like that. I'm going to take a couple of dashes off here. Something like that. So let's say that's good enough. We could also go into the shading and add in a drop shadow just like that. It will give it a little bit of finesse as well. And if we wanted to, we could do a lot of positioning and stuff. But for this tutorial, we are simply not going to. So, again, to make the animation in this way, we'll simply go into our text. And then we'll go into the write on command here. And I'm just going to remove this and go all the way back to zero and make sure that the playhead is right here in the beginning of our animation. And now I'm just going to put in a keyframe. And you know, let's say I want this to be 90 frames. We could do something like that. And now we have done a travel map like that over 90 frames. So here we have a travel map done with the write on command or the write on effect inside of the text editor, which is a pretty nice and cool effect and another way of doing it. So I didn't think you could do this effect in more ways than I already did, but of course you could do it in this way as well. So if we want to add in some coolness to this, of course we could add in a little bit more. Let's take in a let's say we want to have this ellipse tool, which is just a circle. And we're going to take in a background as well. And then we are going to connect the ellipse to the background. I'm just going to push one on my keyboard so we can see our ellipse up here. And let's change the color for that as well. We're going to make this again red, and let's do it something like that. I'll change the size in the ellipse here. So let's make it pretty small, something like that. And I am going to merge this together again by going down to merge one and letting go. And now we have a merge two, and our dot is now merged in. Like that. So if I go into the merge node, I can move my dot around, and I'm going to put it here in the beginning. And in this case, I'm just going to go into the center and sizing here, and I'm going to put in a keyframe. And I'm going to do this pretty fast, going with the arrow keys forward. So the idea here is to move the dot in front of the dotted line, and we are doing this keyframes pretty fast. So I'm sure if you had more time, you could make it look a little bit better. So the thing is, we need to follow the line. So we have an effect like this. So now it's traveling with the dot all the way. And of course, you could do the same thing using a PNG photo of a plane or a boat or whatever. But for this example, I just did it this way. So that is how you do another map effect inside of Fusion, super fast and actually super simple. And again, thanks to Frank for letting me know how to do it this way so I could do this tutorial as well. Anyway, I do hope you found this video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there is a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.